This report is by no means the end of all the things that are going to come out. So we'll have more people on the record, and there's voices that were not heard by the Free Commission that will be in the court of law, and I think that'll help clarify some of these things that are, you know, even Louis Free himself admits that they had to draw some quote-unquote reasonable conclusions. Mm-hmm. And I think the important thing is that, you know, Joe wanted us to pursue the truth wherever it took us, and I don't think we would have stopped off at reasonable conclusions. We want to continue to pursue the truth.
Right, right. I guess the thing that seems still just so challenging to understand is that, you know, if someone comes in and tells you that they saw someone raping a child in the shower, and obviously your father was very distressed by that, and he talked about it with the head of the university the next day, but then nothing happened. I mean, don't you think you'd say something must happen, that you would keep pushing it?
Well, let me clarify that very quickly for you. Mike McQuarrie has testified that he did not come in and say that he saw a young man being raped in the shower. So that's probably an inaccurate characterization of what Mike told him. Mike told him he saw something that wasn't right, something that crossed the line, and Joe reported to his superiors.
Right. He said, well, I'll just put the quote up here. Yeah, let me just, Jay, put the quote up. He said, I told him, Paterno, okay, what I had seen. I made sure he knew that it was sexual and that it was wrong.
Correct, but that it was, you know, something across the line, but not a rape, as has been characterized. It could, and not that any of that's excusable, not that he's right, but Joe reported to his superiors, which is exactly what he's required to do by the Cleary Act. He really could not have stepped outside of that legally. But that being said, he has since said that he wished he'd followed up and pursued it more. And that's what he has said about it, and he's been very clear in that, never wavered.
Are you disappointed a little bit, though, part of you? I mean, I know it's got to be hard. I mean, your dad was a hero, and you love him, and he's your dad, but is part of you a little disappointed?
Disappointed in him?
Yeah.
I think what we have to understand is this. We have a lot more information in 2012 than we did in 2001. We have to understand, when you judge people's actions 11 years ago, you have a lot better context and a lot more information they had there. And you can't necessarily judge people and their actions 11 years ago based on what you know now. Mm-hmm. At the time this was reported to Joe, Jerry had never been charged with the crime. A very obviously somebody who was upset about something he had seen came to him, and Joe went and reported to his superior. So I don't know that I want to condemn somebody or say, yeah, I'm disappointed in him, because I can't tell you. I wasn't in his shoes. And a lot of people would like to say they would have done things differently, but that's just, you know, it's easy to say that now.